Hi, my name is Pai, and I am the pastor of St. Andrew's Streetsville in Mississauga, Canada. May we pause for 5 minutes and think about life, God, and the Bible. In Jesus' time, people who had leprosy had a difficult time. First, the disease affected their body. Not only did they suffer physically, but they had to cover up parts of their body affected by the disease. On top of this, the synagogue and the temple regarded them as unclean people. They were not allowed to attend the services in the synagogue and the temple. Their struggle was not only physical, it was also social. At the end of Mark 1, a man with leprosy approaches Jesus. Mark 1:40. A man with leprosy came to him and begged him on his knees. If you are willing, you can make me clean. Mark 1 verse 40. He wants to be made clean. He wants to get healed. Jesus responds immediately. Mark 1 41 and 42. Jesus was indignant. He reached out his hand and touched the man. I am willing, he said. Be clean. Immediately the leprosy left him and he was clean. Mark 1 41 to 42. Jesus is moved with compassion for this man with leprosy. He reaches out his hand and touches the man. He says to the man, I am willing, be clean. I believe that for this man with leprosy, this is the first time for a long time another human being reaches out and touches him. Mark tells us immediately that the leprosy leaves the man and he is cleansed. First, Jesus is full of compassion for this man with leprosy. Jesus also does something that is forbidden by the synagogue and the temple. He reaches out and touches the man while healing him. In some ways, you can say that Jesus has broken the law of the synagogue and the temple. The synagogue and the temple have declared that people with leprosy are outcast and unclean and should not be touched. In reaching out and touching the man, Jesus has broken the synagogue and temple laws. If you read the Gospel of Mark, you will see that Jesus reaches out to lepers, tax collectors, and sinners, as well as Pharisees and other religious officials. Jesus also reaches out to non-Jews, like the man possessed by many demons in Mark 5 and the Syrophoenician woman and daughter in Mark 7. Jesus breaks down the barriers and reaches out across the divisions created by human beings. Right now, we are going through a period of protests and reflection about anti-black racism since the death of George Floyd due to police brutality. We must repent of our subtle and systemic racism. As a church, we identify with the people of color and pray for God's justice to be done. In some ways, Jesus reaching out and touching the man with leprosy is the model for us. In fact, it is this Jesus who reaches out to every human being, whether they be a man of leprosy, a Pharisee, or a Syrophoenician woman. I grew up in Malaysia, where there are three major ethnic groups of people. When growing up in Malaysia, I have had the experience of sharing life with people from these three groups. They all have their religious preferences, language practices, and food tastes. After I gave my life to Christ when I was 14, I began to see people in a different light. Despite the religious, language, and food differences, all people are created in the image of God. We love them as Jesus would have loved them, no matter how different they are from us. After this healing, Jesus asked the man to go and show himself to the priest and offer sacrifices to prove that he is cleansed under the law of Moses. Instead, the man went into town and shared his experiences freely. Jesus could not enter that town freely. So this man was also healed from a social perspective. When Jesus heals, he heals us totally. It is more than just a physical healing. May we all receive the healing from Jesus. Amen.